For our purposes, there are two types of glaciers. There's really a subtype, but we aren't going to worry about it. There are alpine glaciers and continental glaciers. Alpine glaciers flow through a mountain valley that was once a river valley. So, in other words, there used to be running water flowing through the valley. Because alpine glaciers go through mountain valleys, they are controlled by the configuration of the landscape, which means this. As the Alpine Glacier is going through the valley, if the valley turns, the glacier turns. See the way that works on these glaciers? You can even see down the bottom left, there's a glacier that's turning down the bottom left as well. So, whatever the shape of the valley is, this is going to determine the shape of the glacier in terms of its movement. Okay? A continental glacier is this. These are massive glaciers that cover extensive land areas and are not controlled by the configuration of the underlying land. In other words, they are so massive they go over the tops of the mountains. And because of that, rather than flowing downslope, they move outwards. The two remaining massive continental glaciers on the planet are, of course, in Antarctica and Greenland. The way continental glaciers move is something like this. If you had a griddle on your stove, you know, a griddle that you're going to cook on, and then you took a ladle and you filled it up with pancake batter, tilted the ladle up above the griddle, the pancake batter flows out of the ladle onto the griddle, then it's going to flow outwards from a central raised part of the pancake. That is kind of the way continental glaciers flow. They flow outwards from a central area and are not controlled by the configuration of the underlying landscape, unlike an alpine glacier, which is going to follow the movement of the valley.